With the Crux 1 from Trongsi I got a very compact 3D printer. The print volume is 180x180x170mm and with the dimensions 40x44x41cm including filament spool, the Crux 1 fits on any desk or finds a place on even a crowded workbench. With the small carrying handle on top of the device, the printer can be quickly put away after work is done. To my mind, smaller is better, especially for beginners, and since most prints aren't really large, a small second machine is often a helpful tool for a quick project. A filament sensor and the ability to continue printing after a power failure reduce the risk of failed prints. The Crux 1 is delivered almost fully assembled. Only the frame has to be mounted on the base, the handle, as well as the filament holder, and the glass plate have to be attached. Inside the base, the electronic components are densely packed, but the arrangement looks tidy. The power supply provides an output voltage of 24V at up to 10 amps, corresponding to 240 watts. A microcontroller type STM32 on which the firmware Marlin runs is placed on the mainboard. The modified Marlin source code was sent to me immediately upon request by email. That's totally in the spirit of how open is this gadget. The drivers for the 4 stepper motors are soldered to the circuit board. The Crux 1 has a direct extruder with the components not being hidden under a cover, everything is clearly visible. The Teflon tube runs to the filament sensor at the end of the X-axis and ensures that the plastic wire is fed in smoothly. The X-axis is guided by steel rollers with ball bearings along a steel bar, which in turn is attached to 20x20mm extruded aluminum. The print bed moves along the Y-axis following the same design principle. The Z-axis is guided by plastic rollers with ball bearings, the extruded aluminum here has the dimensions 20x40mm. The backlash of the plastic rollers can be minimized by turning an eccentric nut. The belt tension of the X-axis can be easily adjusted using a small hand wheel. The Y-axis belt tension is adjusted by moving the stepper motor, which is mounted on slotted holes. If everything is adjusted correctly, all axes run smoothly. Leveling of the print bed is done in the classic way by using a sheet of paper to adjust the gap between build plate and nozzle. Since the printhead can be moved to the corner points quickly via the printer menu and due to the large hand wheels, this can be done more quickly than with many printers that have an auto level function. The heated print bed reaches 100 degrees Celsius after 7 minutes, and the maximum temperature of 110 degrees Celsius after 9 minutes. the temperature in my video studio was 24 degrees Celsius at the time of the measurement. A first print job is started quickly via the touchscreen. Print data can be transferred via microSD card, USB interface or USB stick. The first print job is to check the flatness of the build plate. 9 discs are printed, each with a diameter of 50mm and a height of 0.2mm. Details of the test procedure and high resolution photos of the results are available on the website. As you can see, all discs stick well to the print bed, the glass plate is sufficiently flat. Next test is the obligatory Benji. The first boat is printed at a speed of 30mm per second and optimal settings for a good looking print. As always, open your eyes and ears and judge for yourself. Next comes the speed test, which isn't about getting good looking benches but to demonstrate where the printer's weak points are. The higher the print speed, the more obvious the limits of the mechanics become. Benji number 2 is printed at 60mm per second. Benji number 3 with 90mm per second. and Benji number 4 with 120mm per second. Which still works, at least in principle. As always, more about the test procedure and high resolution photos of the results can be found on the website of How Open Is This Gadget. With a compact printer like the Crux One, the maximum material throughput is not that important. Nevertheless, even with small print jobs, the printing time can be reduced noticeably if a lot of plastic can be extruded per unit of time. In this test series, the speed is increased, until the limit is obviously exceeded. The numbers and photos regarding this test series are also on the website. With the values for the maximum material throughput found to be good, a large Benji is printed as the final test. This ship has the dimensions 10x21x16cm. How open the Crux One from Trongsy is, high resolution photos of the results and all technical specs can be found on the website of How Open Is This Gadget. With that you can get your own impression of the print quality the Crux One delivers, without anyone babbling of what you should think about the results. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!